Good evening to all. Breaking of DC motors is a topic now we are going to know. At the end of this video lecture, students can understand clearly about the meaning of the breaking, classification of breaking, comparison between the classifications of breaking, and the breaking involved in DC shunt and series motors. Those details can be understood clearly. First of all, we have to know what is breaking. Breaking is a generic term used to describe set of operating conditions for electric drive systems. They are: first one, rapid stopping of the motor; second one, holding the motor shaft to a specific position; third one, maintaining the speed to a desired value of preventing the motor from overspeeding. Rapid stopping means quick stopping or sudden stopping. There are two types of braking available. One is electrical braking, another one is mechanical braking. So dear students, the term braking refers not only stopping of the motor, it also includes holding the motor shaft to a specific position and speed control of that particular motor. All are involved under the term of braking. Comparison of electrical and mechanical braking. Let us take five parameters. They are maintenance, energy utilization, smoothness of braking, equipment holding. Now we are going to discuss these parameters one by one for electrical braking and mechanical braking. If you take maintenance, we need a little maintenance for electrical braking because dust-free operation due to absence of mechanical equipment. But in mechanical braking, mechanical brakes require frequent maintenance, adjustment of brakes and replacement of brake linings due to wear and tear. If you take the parameter of energy utilization in electrical braking, energy of rotating parts can be converted to electrical energy. This can be utilized or returned to the mains during braking. Whereas in mechanical braking, energy of rotating parts is wasted as heat in friction. Heat is generated during braking. Braking is smooth without snatching in electrical braking, but in mechanical braking, depending on conditions, braking may not be smooth. If you consider equipment of higher rating than the motor rating may be required in certain braking application. It is for electrical braking. Whereas for mechanical, equipment like brake shoes, brake lining, brake drum are required. Then the parameter of holding torque. If you consider electrical braking, to producing holding torque, electrical energy is required for operation. If you consider mechanical braking, it can be applied to hold the rotating part or shaft at a particular position only. At the end, we can conclude that the maintenance free operation or little maintenance and smoothness of operation and producing the holding torque, all are easy and simple in electrical braking, whereas it is difficult in mechanical braking. There are three types of electrical braking, namely rheostatic braking or dynamic braking, plugging or counter current braking, and it is also called as reverse current braking. And the last one is regenerative braking. Let us discuss one by one. First of all, students should know the meaning of regenerative braking. In the regenerative braking operation, the motor operates as a generator while it is still connected to the supply. Here, the motor speed is greater than the synchronous speed. If the motor is DC motor, means at the time, the speed of motor will be greater than the no load speed. Mechanical energy is converted into electrical energy, part of which is returned to the supply and the rest as heat in the winding or bearing. Next one, dynamic braking. In this method of braking, the motor is disconnected from the supply the field connections are reversed and the motor is connected in series with a variable resistance R. And the last one is plugging. The plugging operation can be achieved by changing the polarity of the motor, thereby reversing the direction of rotation of the motor. This can be achieved in AC motor by changing the phase sequence and in DC motors by changing the polarity. Now we need to know about electrical braking in DC shunt motor. As we discussed earlier, these three types of braking going to apply in DC shunt motor and DC series motor. Now we have seen about DC shunt motor. Look at the circuit diagram of rheostatic braking in DC shunt motor. As we discussed, the input terminals disconnected from the supply and it is connected with the variable resistance. Look at the graph. We have considered torque in negative x-axis, speed in positive y-axis. The resultant line drawn in second quadrant, this is called forward braking quadrant. Next one, plugging. In plugging, we are interchanging the polarities of supply. This is the corresponding circuit diagram. Here we are interchanging the polarities of input supply, that is armature terminals, plus minus going to interchange like minus plus. Look at the diagram. At the time of plugging, the torque is traveled from positive polarity to negative polarity, and then speed is gradually reduced. After point C, it rotates in opposite direction of the rotation. Then regenerative braking. In regenerative braking of DC shunt motor, back EMF becomes greater than supply voltage. In this braking, motor acts as generator. Look at the graph. In x-axis we have taken torque, in y-axis we have taken speed. In this braking, motor acts as generator, as I said earlier. Here the torque is traveled from positive polarity to negative polarity and then reaches zero. This is what the various braking involved in DC shunt motor. Next one, electric braking in DC series motor. This is a circuit diagram for rheostatic braking, where the variable rheostat connected across the supply terminals and the corresponding graph. In this graph, we have resultant curve in second quadrant, that is forward braking. Next one, plugging. Here we are interchanging the polarities of supply. Here we have all the four quadrants of operation. Actually, plugging involved in either second or fourth quadrant operation only. But in this diagram, you are seeing both first and third quadrant also, because the graph shows how the torque changed from positive polarity to negative polarity and how the speed changed from its normal rotation to opposite side rotation. And the last one is regenerative braking. In DC series motor, regenerative braking is not possible without necessary modifications, because reversal of armature current would result in reversal of field and hence of back EMF. Dear students, kindly understand that regenerative braking is not so easy in series motor. Because of the series connections of armature coil and field coil, it is not possible. Thank you all.